got some more decimal arithmetic that you may already know how to do, but I want to focus again on why it works. And you know how we're going to do that. We're going to look at the place values of each of the digits. We've got 7.24. The 7 is in the units place, so that's 7 times 10 to the 0. The 2 is in the tenths place. It's 2 times 10 to the minus 1, and the 4 is out there in the hundredths place. 4 times 10 to the minus 2. And then we multiply by 10. So 7.24 times 10, and we're going to multiply by 10 by multiplying each term here by 10. We're just doing the distributive property. When we multiply this by 10, the 10 to the 0 times 10 gives us 10 to the first. We multiply this term by 10. 10 to the minus 1 times 10 to the first gives us 10 to the 0. And then the last term here, 10 to the minus 2 times 10 to the first, minus 2 plus 1, that gives us 10 to the minus 1. And all we're doing here, multiplying each term by 10, is increasing the exponent in each power of 10 by 1. And now we can easily just read off the places, the decimal places here, of the result. So we got a 7 in the tens place. That's a 7. 2 in the units place. And then a 4 in the tenths place. 72.4. We just read off the decimal places and we see that sure enough, all we do when we multiply by 10 is we move the decimal point 1 to the right and we get 72.4. Let's try another one. Here we're going to multiply by 100 instead of just 10. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to look at the place values in our original number. We've got the 1 in the tenths place, so that's 1 times 10 to the minus 1. And then the 3 is out there in the thousandths place. That's 3 times 10 to the minus 3. Not minus 2, there are no hundredths. That's what that 0 is telling us, saying no hundredths here. So we've got 1 times 10 to the minus 1 plus 3 times 10 to the minus 3, and we're going to multiply that by 100. Now 100 is just 10 squared. And again, we're just going to multiply each of these terms by 10 squared. We're doing the distributive property here. Multiply this by 10 squared. 10 to the minus 1 times 10 to the 2. Add the exponents. You get 10 to the first. Again, all we're doing is increasing the exponent by 2. We do the same thing with the other term. We multiply it by 10 to the second. And we get 10 to the minus 1. Just adding 2 onto the power of 10. Onto the exponent. And now, again, we can just read the digits off of our answer. We got a 1 in the tens place, and the 3 is in the tenths place. We have no units. We have nothing in the ones, but we need to include the 0. We can't write 1.3, because that would move the 1 into the ones place, not the tens place. And we can't just write 1.3, that would be 13, but the 3 is out here in the tenths place. The 0 is extremely important. You can't forget the zeros for these missing digits. And we see, again, multiplying by 100, that's multiplying by 2 tens, that's moving the decimal point 2 places to the right, and we get 10.3. Now that we can handle multiplication, we'll move on to division. Once again, we'll look at the place values, 23.4. The 2's in the tens place, 2 times 10 to the first. The 3 is in the ones place, 3 times 10 to the 0, and the 4 is in the tenths place. 4 times 10 to the minus 1. Now here comes the tricky part. We're dividing instead of multiplying. Dividing by 10,000 is the same thing as multiplying by the reciprocal of 10,000. Well, 10,000 is 10 to the fourth. The reciprocal of 10 to the fourth is 10 to the negative fourth. So when we're dividing by 10 to the fourth, that's the same thing as multiplying by 10 to the minus 4. Now we're just going to do the same thing we did on the last two problems. We're going to multiply each of these terms by 10 to the minus 4. Multiply this one by 10 to the minus 4. So you get 10 to the first times 10 to the minus 4th. Again, we add the exponents. 1 plus a negative 4 gives me 2 times 10 to the negative 3rd. We just moved the exponent down by 4. That's what happens when we multiply by 10 to the negative 4th. Do the same thing here. And we'll get 3 times 10 to the minus 4. We multiply 10 to the 0 times 10 to the minus 4. Then we multiply 10 to the minus 1 times 10 to the minus 4. Sure enough, we get 10 to the minus 5th. And all we've done here when we're multiplying by 10 to the minus 4 is we're reducing each exponent of each of these powers of 10 by 4. Once again, we can now read the digits off. We can just read the digits in our answer. We've got nothing to the left of the decimal point, so I'm going to put a big old zero out there to remind me of that. I'm going to put 0 point, because we got no ones, no tens, nothing up there. We have no tenths. We have no hundredths. Very important to include these zeros. We can't put the first digit right up there next to the decimal point, because the first digit isn't in the tenths place. It's way out here in the thousandths place. And we've got 3 in the next place, and then a 4 in the next place. 2 in the thousandths, 3 in the 10,000ths, 4 in the 100,000ths. And we see that what's happening when we're dividing by powers of 10, instead of moving the decimal point to the right, we're moving the decimal point to the left. We're dividing here by 10 to the 4th, so we have to move the decimal point 4 places. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we drop in the extra zeros to show that we've moved the decimal point, those extra spaces to the left. And here's our final answer, and we're done.